Hello, fabulous Gemini. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of January 2020. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And of course, all the attention, all the glamour, all the mystery, what everybody's been talking about is the conglomerate of planets that are taking place in the sign of Capricorn. Now for you, this is a part of the sky that is connected to profound and meaningful transformation. It is connected to your relationship with financial institutions as well. It isn't just Pluto meeting Saturn in the sky and in this part of the sky for you, but the fact that the sun is there, identity is wrapped up in what is transpiring in this area. Mercury is there, mind and thoughts and communications and documents and contracts, all of that is wrapped up as part of the developments that are taking place. But I actually think that what is going to help us to make a really powerful connection, an emotional connection, if you will, to this part of the sky is the fact that this stellium of planets is happening across the sky from a lunar eclipse. Now, the lunar eclipse happens right around the 10th. This stellium of planets perfects right around the 12th. So you can see how that period of time there is especially lit up, celestially speaking. The lunar eclipse will bring to an end eclipse season for now. And because of all these planets across the sky, there's that much more intensity to the way in which we are experiencing the closures that are promised by this lunar eclipse. Now, this is a part of the sky for you that has to do with money you earn and money you spend. It has to do with self-esteem and self-worth. It has to do with possessions as well. I feel like there is some moment of honesty and some moment of fruition that is set to transpire for you. Now, for some people, this energy is going to be deeply personal, for some Geminis out there, rather. And for those Geminis, this is going to be a time when you are transforming and making real what it means to truly value yourself, to believe in yourself, to love yourself. And it can be a truly regenerative time on a level of what is happening psychologically. There are changes that are taking place, transformations that are happening for you on levels of psyche, but also physically as well, that are informing a connection to self-esteem and self-worth. And in this way, this time can be incredibly valuable in that it connects you with an authentic self-love that stays with you long after this time is over. For others, though, this energy may very well play out in the context of what's happening financially. Now, the thing is that when we have such strong financial energy, it means the money you need is there. So that's the good news. It is that the universe wants you to understand some deeper spiritual lessons as you engage in understanding prosperity and finances and abundance in your life. And this energy can be profoundly healing. For some, this is going to be a time of some power deal, some financial settlement that could show up for you. For others still, though, this could be a time when you realize that what is worth doing for the money and what isn't, well, that has changed for you. And there's a desire to move towards income and how you're spending as well, to move it towards a direction that feels more real, more authentic, and more honestly rooted in whom it is that you are and whom it is that you know yourself to be. And in this way, it is this energy that can align you with a source of income and prosperity that is much more rewarding than what you have known before. There's always that little bit of a moment when change is taking place that can have us questioning. But ultimately, with so much very stable energy at this time, it does suggest that whatever may be changing, you are moving towards more solid ground, certainly in the bigger picture of your life. Now, as we navigate late into the month, that is when we are going to have a new moon. This new moon happens right around the 24th, and it happens in fellow air sign Aquarius. Now, the fact that's in fellow air sign means that you're able to tap into this energy more easily. And what I do love about this new moon is that it is speaking in harmony with Chiron. That is a beautiful, supportive energy. And it is an energy ultimately of your friends, because where Chiron is, your friends being a healing presence in your life. However, what is also happening is Uranus. Uranus in the sign just before your speaking intention with this new moon. Now, this new moon happens in a part of the sky that has to do with understanding your place in the world, long distance travel, immigration, citizenship, higher learning, legal matters, political matters are covered here. And there may very well be new opportunities that show up for you to do some traveling and to move forward, whether it is with a legal matter or in terms of your own beliefs, the philosophies that guide your life. Whatever does come up, though, there is that surprise element to it because of the Uranian connection. However, it looks like your friends are tremendously helpful. They bring in healing energy. They bring in an energy of awareness on your part. And ultimately, this is designed to help you to understand yourself as part of a larger world. This may expand your worldview in an instant. Now, for some, I do feel like all of us, you know, we have our preconceptions, we have our prejudices as well. And I think for some Geminis out there, this could be a moment where you realize your own preconceptions and where it is that they haven't been fair. And that in turn can facilitate that more profound healing that ultimately moves you towards being a more wise and loving citizen in the world. But for others, this energy might be a lot more practical. Like if it is that you are in an institute of higher learning, whether you work there or you're a student there, this can be a time when you're experiencing changes, whether it's personally in terms of where it is that you have changed and you want your educational journey to be different, or externally as well in terms of the behavior of your professors, which might be a little erratic at this time. For those of you who are engaged in a legal matter, things could move very quickly at this time, perhaps coming to resolution very quickly as well. And if it is that you are in a process of immigration or citizenship, this can also be a time when you feel like things are moving very quickly as well. With that beautifully supportive energy of Chiron, you are empowered thanks to the people you know at this time. So whatever needs to surprise you, I often say that there are not enough surprises in life. So you let it surprise you, let it be what it needs to be, and then you move forward and all is well and all will be well. And it very likely is going to be the case that the people you know help you to make things better than they were before. Whatever it is that does come up, remember there's something about it that needs to be addressed. It might be your own beliefs. It might be an external matter, but you address it and you move forward and you are that much stronger and better for it as well. Now, where it comes to matters of love, the first half of the month, Venus will continue to move through fellow air sign Aquarius, the same part of the sky that the new moon takes place in late in the month. But in the second half of the month, Venus will move into the very top of your sky. So for those of you open to meeting someone new, I do feel like it is the international love that calls you in the first half of the month. But by the time we get to the second half of the month, you're thinking a lot more big picture, a lot more consequential when it comes to meeting new people. And it is possible that you may meet somebody who either has achieved something that you desire to achieve for yourself or is in a position of authority. Now, what you do with that is always up to you to decide in light of your unique circumstances. Now, for those of you who are just starting to date somebody, I like the very adventurous spirit that is playing out in the first half of the month. I think that can encourage the two of you to have a lot of fun together, to try new things and have new experiences. It is in the second half of the month that you may very well be feeling a greater sense of wanting to be connected to this person more, wanting to see a future for the two of you that could be possible. And because you are thinking very big picture, if you see it with this person, well, chances are you'll continue to move forward. But if it starts to become clear that this may not be the person for the big picture, you'll start to be more honest with yourself about that now. And for those of you who are in an established bond, I do really love the energy of Venus in fellow air sign for you. It does suggest that the two of you might start planning something, an adventure together, travel together. All of that is possible. But it may be that in the second half of the month, things start getting a little bit more big picture, whether you start getting a lot more goal-oriented or there are goals revealed for the two of you. But you might have at least one or two distinct moments where your partner serves as cheerleader for you in the second half of the month in a way that you appreciate very much. What I love about this month for you, well, look, something I haven't even mentioned yet, and that is the fact that the very beginning of the month, Mars does move into your opposite sign. Now, this, on the one hand, can be a tiring energy, but it can also be an energy that invites you to consider the people in your life and how it is that they evoke you and inspire you or fuel your determination to move towards your goals. This can be, on the one hand, a very passionate energy, but it can also feel as if other people are being demanding in your life. Now, what I do love about this in particular, though, is that you may find yourself truly feeling inspired and encouraged by the one-on-one alliances that you have. And in this way, know that there are people around you now that absolutely support a best and better version of yourself than you knew before. Well, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the 2020 year ahead special horoscope preview for your sign coming up right now. But of course, if you want to get a video like this every single week, log on to NadiaShaw.com, sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive video scopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy. Hello, fabulous superstar Gemini. Welcome to your horoscope for the year of 2020. This is your special horoscope for the year ahead. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing year it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. So whenever it is that I'm making these year ahead videos, there's always so much to talk about, right? So much to look at. And so a part of what I need to do is to really hone in on the things that I think are going to be most important for your sign and for Geminis in this case. And there are two big events that by far are the most important for all the Geminis out there. One goes beyond this year and one is a little bit more localized. So let's start with the longer trend. Right around the end of May, beginning of June, that is when the nodes of the moon are going to change signs and the north node will move into your sign. Now this event happens about